now standing in front of the main gate of the former biggest Nazi concentration and death camp. It was the center of extermination of four main national groups: Jews, Poles, Gypsies, and Soviet prisoners of war. In addition to these, many Czechs, Austrians, Yugoslavians, and others were put to death. And the history of Auschwitz can be divided into two periods. First, between 1940 and 1942. For the first 2 years of the camp's existence, Auschwitz was a concentration camp only for men, and most of these prisoners were Polish political prisoners. And second period, between 1942 and 1945, in which the majority of the prisoners were Jewish prisoners. Since 1942, Auschwitz was also an extermination camp, the biggest extermination camp for Jews from occupied countries in Europe. And Auschwitz was a complex of three camps. We will see two of these camps. The main camp, Auschwitz I, built at first in 1940. I would like to show you also the second camp, Auschwitz II, Birkenau. The second camp was huge. It was 20 times bigger than the main camp. There was also a third camp called Auschwitz III Monowitz, but that camp was completely destroyed after Auschwitz was liberated by the Soviet Army in January 1945. Okay, so in the main camp in Auschwitz I, there were 28 buildings in which prisoners were housed. In each block like this one you can see in front of us, approximately 700 prisoners were housed, between 700 and 1,000. You can see that the camp was surrounded by double row of electrified barbed wire and sentry towers. On November 11th, 1943, 54 Polish political prisoners were shot in one day at Wolodet. They were shot here because they were accused of military activity. On May 27th, 1942, 168 Polish actors and performers were arrested in Kraków. They were transported here and they were also executed at Wolodet. And they were shot here in revenge for attack against high officer of SS. Just for that, 168 Polish actors were executed here, and they had nothing to do with this attack. They were just killed in revenge. And regardless of the time of the year, prisoners that were shot at the Wall of Death were shot naked. First women, then men, individually or in twos, with a bullet to the back of the head.
How do you feel about visiting Auschwitz?
Well, anxious, because I don't really know what's going to be happening or what it's like, so just seeing pictures, it's nothing compared to the real thing.
What do you expect when you get there?
It's really hard to expect anything at the moment, because nothing like it, is there?
I don't know, really. It's going to be quite weird, and I'm probably not saying out, just keep really quiet, so...
How do you think it will change your views on the Holocaust?
Well, last time I went, it changed the way I looked at the world. I look at it totally different today, and what just one person can do, and yeah.
Probably a bit strange because we're going with like Polish people, and they might have a history with it, like grandparents or great grandparents and stuff. So you won't know how to react to it.
I just expect it to be quiet, and all the pictures you've seen, like dark and grim and quiet. Oh, I can't say shit, can I?
I expect the atmosphere is going to be very, very thick. I can feel it being very, very sad, very dark. Much as you would expect, almost like a cemetery or a very old church to be at times, but just that really, that extra step of magnitude.
I'll be more aware of it, so... I don't know, can influence other people.
I expect it to be different to the second time. I expect it to see things I didn't see before. And I expect group to be different reaction from the group as well. Because before we had Polish, Germans and English, but this time it's just us and the Poles. What do you expect when you get there? You got any expectations?
I don't know, I expect it to be quite scary. Because it's kind of unimaginable, so...
I'm quite nervous about what it's going to be like. Want to see what it's like, and I don't know, I think it'll be weird to experience and just see how bad the conditions were and kind of get a sense of what it must have been like for all them people.
What do you hope to gain from the visit?
Greater understanding of the Holocaust.
How do you think it will change your views on the Holocaust?
It'd make it more real.
How do you feel about visiting Auschwitz tomorrow?
I've got mixed feelings. I've been several times before, and each time different bits get to you. So the first time I went, say after about 10-15 minutes, I was just sort of like totally numb with it, and each time I've gone, I've seen a little bit more, got a little bit deeper into it. I mean, it's a subject that's fascinated me the Holocaust for many years, and I usually find something else there as well. But I think for me, one of the things I'm a bit wary of or apprehensive of is being able to support everyone else through it.
Yeah, I'd just like to echo what Steve said. I've never been to Auschwitz before, but I have been reading a lot of books about Auschwitz, about the Holocaust, and I feel like I'm really familiar now with the text and with everything that happened there from reading it. As for seeing it, I'm obviously a little bit apprehensive as to how I'm going to feel, because it will be the realisation of everything that I've read, and I think it's very, very difficult for the human mind to compute, if you like.
I'm quite nervous, at the same time a little bit excited about going, and I feel a bit bad about saying that. Again, like the others, I've done quite a lot of sort of research into it, and I think that's kind of the excitement about going to Auschwitz after I've done all that research. I think the other thing as well, pretty much what Steve's saying, is, you know, we're the support for the others in the group, and I think if it affects us so much that, you know, we're getting really upset about it, is that going to have a knock-on effect, you know, to the young people in particular?
Thank you.
It's really hard because I don't know.
Okay. How did you find the experience?
Well, sometimes it's very sad, isn't it? And when you think about it, you just stop and imagine the German guards there and everyone else crowding around. It's like, oh my God, how could someone have... And it's so planned and it's all just there. It's just weird. It's not a very nice place, is it?
Was it what you expected, and if not, what was different?
It was, but I think I just didn't remember the scale of it from last time, especially the Birkenau site. It's massive. I didn't walk around it the first time I did today, but it's huge. Mm-hmm. I knew it was a mile down the track, a mile to the other end, but when you walk around the thing, it's quite big.
Yeah.
It's just weird seeing it, what you'd seen on films and in pictures and documentaries, actually there in front of you. It's quite different from what you've seen about it. It's quite different when you actually got there and hit home more about what actually went off there and what were happening there.
How did you find the experience?
Quite emotional and quite reflecting, because you don't realise what you've got until you realise what little people had when you were there. That some people even paid for tickets to go there. Just a bit weird.
Was it what you expected, and if not, what were different?
No, it was just proper real. Yeah. I expected, you know, like a museum. Yeah. I expected it to be like stuff like that, all pictures and stuff, but they were like things preserved from back then, like bedrooms and stuff. It was just horrible.
How did you find the experience?
A bit sickening. It, like, you look at stuff and you think, how could a person just decide that they're going to do that to millions of other people? What kind of thoughts went through their head to make them want to start a Nazi camp and kill all the Jews and people that they just didn't like?
Yeah.
It's like, and the scale that it were on, it's just like, wow.
Yeah.
That actually happened. It's not just something you read about. It's like, it made it more real.
Mm. How did you find the experience?
I thought it was like a surreal experience, kind of strange in a way. But I'm really glad I went, because you found out so much about it.
Yeah.
Kind of got an insight into it, the perspective, really. Mm.
What were your initial thoughts when you entered Auschwitz?
Thought I'd cry.
No, I didn't.
Amazingly, I just felt numb.
How did you find the experience?
Weird. It's like I wanted to be sick, but I couldn't be sick, and you know, you just wanted to cry, but you couldn't cry because you were too numb,
mm-hmm.
and it was just very, very daunting.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, I was quite numb really, and I didn't know what to expect, but I knew that it was going to be upsetting, and I don't know, I just didn't really think. I was just so taken back by everything, what were there and what it's shown you and how it's laid out, because you don't have a break in between anything. You're like moving on to the next building, so it's like everything hits you at once, and it's so hard to take it all in.
How did you find the experience?
Quite shocking actually, because I don't know, you're like, it's not what you expect, far from it, and you don't realise how harsh it is till you get there and you see the actual size of it, and then it's just, well, completely goes over the top of the head, how big it is and how somebody could have thought of something like that, so.
Yeah. How did you find the experience?
I found it... I don't really understand how it happened still. It's not really one of the things where you go to it, you learn about it, and you understand it. It's one of the things that no matter how many times you go to, you'll never be able to fully understand it. And you'll, no matter how much research you do into it, I don't think you actually understand how it happened.
It brings it to life
more
than anything.
How did you find the experience?
I found it very, very interesting. It was something that I needed. I needed to understand the depth and the complexity of the whole situation.
Mm-hmm.
It's not as easy as just saying, oh, the Nazis did this because that's the way they did it. There's a whole lot more to it, and if you don't understand that, if you don't open your mind to that, you're never going to understand mm-hmm. the two. As you approached it, you can tell that you're coming to it. It's the atmosphere of it, it definitely, you can feel it. It's, the tension rises. It almost feels claustrophobic mm-hmm. when you're coming down, you know, when you approach it. And when you're in there, even if you're in a wide open space, it's a very sort of claustrophobic feeling. You know exactly what's happened. You know, you don't really understand why, but it's very real, and it really had that mm-hmm. sort of third party.
Yeah. Was it what you expected, and if it wasn't, what were different?
To be honest, the weather. I didn't expect it to be so sunny. It was
yeah.
that kind of thing where you always seem to expect it to be dark, gloomy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to just give it that tragic feeling. But
yeah.
the weather, it almost brought out sort of a new hope that it would never happen again. You think about it, and Auschwitz and the other concentration camps would be almost like a scar on the planet. It's always going to be there, it's never going to heal, and you'll always see it, but it just reminds you that never to do it again, and I think that's important to remember.
Yeah.